इफ यू डिड नॉट सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल येट, सो प्लीज गो टू द सब्सक्राइब बटन रेड कलर एंड क्लिक दिस, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गेट नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ ईच वीडियो सो सेलेक्ट ऑल हियर. So now you have subscribed our channel, you will get new video every time. Hello everyone. Last time we told you about the WordPress, that how to resemble or assemble WordPress and what is the working of your cylinder. And also this is the pipe of your refill valve pipe, and this is the only demo that show here. That this is red color, suppose that your surge valve and this is the refill valve opening and closing. And also that one demo is here, that valve. Also we are about the valve function, you know that we already have told you about the valve video. You can watch there and you can learn that how to work this valve, what is the working of this valve. And today we are going to tell you that what is the circuit of this. First we will tell you about the what is this, that first we will talk here that we make this drawing in our PowerPoint and as per our programming of PLC also we will tell you here everything we will describe here. That master valve, this is the master valve and this is the relief valve, and we will fix one relief valve here, and this is for slide, for both slide and up and down and your locking. That pressure switch, this is the pressure switch, and here that you can see that this is the incoming, that up and down, and this is the slide in and slide out, this is the up and down, and also this is the NRV, first NRV and one valve for your this locking and your prefill valve. This is the prefill valve we mention here, and this is the locking valve. When pressure will come 170, it will be work, that circuit will be open. So that is the equation of your hydraulic circuit. You can take a screenshot of it if you want. This is total, that this is our tank and heat exchanger. After heat exchanger, it is going to that when coming incoming line, that heat exchanger here, pressure is going after pump, motor is making the pressure, master valve. And extra pressure, it will be that master valve will or relief valve will deliver to your tank, return to tank. And also one line is going to your prefill valve and locking valve, and locking and prefill, and also that in your locking, that locking the pressure switch is there. One pipeline to reach the pressure, so it will work. And also one valve for your up and down circuit. And that Q4, Q5, Q3, Q2 and Q3, Q2 and Q3 for your slide cylinder. So we mention here that this is the output. Q is showing that this is the output. We will talk in our circuit that this is Q2, Q3 slide in or slide out only. Now that we will start that this is the motor, our motor. When to save the our electricity, when our we need some function of hydraulics, at that time it will be start, because holding time of your rubber press when it will be closed for 10 minutes, so no need to start or run this motor that time. To save the energy, we can stop this motor. And also master valve, when we use all any function, that time we will use that master valve, supply should be come. And also that slide and upstairs, and there are only 6 functions are there without this master valve. So because master valve and your hydraulic motor will get supply at the same time, and this heat exchanger will work your through that some fresh water from your cooling tower. Also you can use to reduce the temperature of your hydraulic oil. This is the equation, and now we will start our chapter. You know that last time we told you about the that to make that one control panel, that voltmeter for each your line, that RYB, that this is the phase and this is the neutral. And also one contactor for your hydraulic motor. Hydraulic meter motor means this motor, this is the hydraulic motor. And that MCB, and this is the CT, and how it will work, please watch our previous video. And also that overload will work, and hydraulic motor in star connection only. So RYB1 and B1 get hydraulic motor. When this contact will be on, hydraulic motor will be on. Now here, that in each panel, when you are making the controlling, so need one control system. So that is the we make that the transformer 380. 380 means that two phase, or we can go with 220. So only here R and B, and if suppose that this is 220. So if we will make that 220, so it means that we need here neutral. So neutral means that one phase and one neutral. So that time you will get 220 voltage. You have to fix here neutral. That is no issue. That what make of the transformer you have to read instruction on the transformer, and we need 24 volt EC because we are making the our cylinder in our circuit in 24 volt EC. That this is the auxiliary contact, that controlling contactor, that 100 V marks for neutral and 111 mark for your 24 volt DC AC. Sorry. So that 2 point we have taken the in the input of your contactor, controlling contactor, one for output input and one for your output, and neutral will be same. So that you can see that 112 we have taken for input circuit and output circuit we have separated, because when suppose that some problem will be you are facing some problem or problem will come, so if you fix that separate input, so that time you can fix one fuse here on fuse, which fuse is broken, so you can understand where is the problem, that in output circuit or input circuit. If you are going with the PLC, so that time you have to fix here SMPS or some condenser or also bridge that with the diode, and after that filter also. So you can make yourself, or otherwise you can take you can buy a SMPS simple mode power supply from the market accordingly your load. That load means that 10 ampere or 5 ampere. What is the load of your machine? You know better. If you know, so you can contact me. I will tell you here that 111, that 111 is that 24 volt EC, 100 is that your neutral. After fixing one fuse, one emergency, and controlling system same, that on, and this is a stop, on, stop, start, stop, and this is the in the series of your on, that you have to fix that this is the coil of your contactor. This coil you have to take the NO of this contactor and put here in the series of your on. So when you will push this, so that time this will be on, because stop is in close condition, and when current will be come, so that time it will be on, so current will pass through this, so it will be on. When you will if you don't want to run this, so that time stop, you can push, so that time it will be stop. Or if somebody will need some emergency there and some mishappened, so that time you can push emergency, one emergency on your control panel, and one emergency must be on your machine panel, the operating hand panel also. So if a proper operator or your some person feels some unhappen or something, so that time he can push the emergency and machine will be stopped, because controlling is stopped now. So that is the means of controlling also. Here you can see that 112 for input, 112 is for input, and 212 for your output circuit. So first we will learn, we have to know that what is the manual and what is the circuit of your that 112 means, and 212, and also that here that 112, that input circuit, we put one selector switch for your manual is 150. We marked it, we have given the number, you can give your number, because we have taken the more difference number here, because we want to teach you. If suppose that your number of 140 is empty, so you can use that is not a matter. So 150 for manual and 130 for your automatic. First we will talk about manual now. So we will tell you about auto also. So here that this phase, and also that this input from machine, In portable power machine, that there are the only two functions: one close, open close, and one slide in and out. Only for, and one command we will get that pressure switch. I told you that pressure switch will work when your machine will take the more pressure that one. What you have, what do you want, and after taking the locking, pressure switch will be open. So pressure switch input will come to your panel to control your circuit. So limit switch in, limit switch out. It means press in. This is press out. Limit switch down, press down. Limit switch up means press. When press will be go upside, that time it will be on. So it will be on. So that relay will be on. So we operate four, five relay with your input. The limit in, limit out, limit. Because we will tell you how to make the PLC circuit also and control diagram. So this is the input, and pressure switch relay will operate when pressure will come. So that time in auto circuit, in automatic circuit, pressure relay will be operate directly when pressure will come. So that is one and no. Also here you can see pressure switch, this is, so it will be operated when auto command will be when that will come. So it will be work in automatic system only. This is the input, and also this is the hydraulic output, hydraulic circuit. Hydraulic circuit means that slide in, so valve should be open, will be run, slide out. This is the sign of your valve. Slide in, slide out, slide down, press up, and prefill valve. Prefill valve means that when it will be open, when it will be work, when your press will go or downside. So we have taken that they have press down or press upside. And pressure switch command will come when your locking will be completed. That time pressure switch will be work. So locking will be stopped when pressure switch command will be come. Because pressure switch command, through this command we have fixed one relay here. We are making, we make this drawing accordingly your PLC circuit. Now that is the equation of your this hydraulic circuit, and also that hydraulic motor and your master valve. One hydraulic motor should be start, and also master valve will work. When function, that hydraulic motor, when it should be start, when your function slide in, slide out, press up, press down, or locking, that time need pressure. So that time we use our hydraulic motor. Or also same that when any valve will be open, so the operate, that time is, this should be operate. So this is the equation of your master valve also. We have taken this output, this input from your input circuit, this relay. When relay will be open and our circuit will be tell, so required, so that time supply will come in the, inside of this. So guys, next time we will tell you about the circuit of our auto and manual in one logic, in one meeting only. So next time we will tell you all things. So till then, thank you very much.